Yeah, so I'm Brandy Shimabukuro. I'm the manager of communications for the Hawaiian Humane Society. And before we dive into things, Sandy, I really want to acknowledge and respect people's choices, right? What I love about National Mutt Day, or here in Hawaii, we like to call it National Poi Dog Day, because mutt just seems to have a negative connotation, and I think there comes with it this stigma that a mixed breed dog is lesser than a purebred dog, and poi dog is just a common colloquialism and an expected term of an accepted term here in Hawaii for a mixed breed dog that has actual it comes from the actual Hawaiian term that referenced an actual breed that was the origins of the Polynesian dog that was brought over by Polynesians here to Hawaii. And so in this day and age, we call them poi dogs. I like to call, the Hawaiian Humane Society has everything and anything that you could possibly imagine. And what I love about National Poi Dog Day is it raises awareness for the fact that there are so many mixed breed dogs available in shelters, in addition to purebred dogs, because we kind of get everything and anything that comes to us from owners who just can't provide for them. But I really want to kick this off by acknowledging the choices that people have, right? At the end of the day, the unifying aspect of pet ownership is you're providing a loving home for pets. And if you're going to a responsible breeder that's, using ethical breeding practices, do your research, find the right pet that's, ideal for your home, your household, your family, your lifestyle. And you can do that at a shelter. You can do that with a responsible breeder. When you're looking at something like National Poi Dog Day, it's just elevating the choices that people have that are outside of the realm of just going to a breeder, right? And there is a dog for everybody. There is a pet for everybody. I believe that very firmly. And it's understanding that you have a certain lifestyle and you want to find the right pet for you, whether that's based off of breed or genetics and what's right for your family and your home, or it's really looking at going into a shelter and finding the dog that has the right personality for you.
That's wonderful. I'm so glad that you said that because I don't want to disparage people who do make different choices, but more educating people on choices that they do have is, you know what I mean? So yeah, absolutely. Well, let's talk about excuse me. Let's talk about adopting these poi dogs, and especially the ones who are older.
I feel, when you make the choice to add a furry family member to your home, you really want to get the whole family together and look at what are the best needs for you, right? And the average family who has, two working parents that have a 9 to 5 or something in and around that range, right? They're leaving the home for a significant amount of time. Maybe they're balancing, extracurriculars, their children's activities, or just having a lifestyle that doesn't require them to be at home all the time, or they don't have a whole lot of time. Period, right? To train a puppy. This is where I love to direct folks to say, you know what? Come into the shelter and give an adult dog a chance, right? Whether that's a dog that's 2 years old, 5 years old, 8 years old, or even older than that, because it's really looking at what can you provide in terms of a loving home and enrichment and exercise. And the average person doesn't have a lot of time for a puppy. They do take a lot of time because you're potty training, you're going through basic socialization and obedience, you're setting boundaries, and you're dealing with a tiny little velociraptor in your home that you're going to be putting a lot of time into to get them tired, to get them to that point of being a cuddly little friend in your home versus an adult dog that has gotten past that stage in their lives, right? The reality is when you're looking at an adult dog or a puppy, how much time you have to commit to them is something you should be considering as a responsible pet owner, because you want to set them up for success. And that's what I love about older dogs specifically, that they just are a little bit mellower. I, speaking from personal experience, I have two really large dogs. One that I adopted, they're both foster fails, or what I like to say, foster fits. But one came to me at four or 5 months old, a former parvo puppy that was in recovery. And the other came to me, I think she was about 2 to 3 years old at different stages of their lives, right? And my first dog that I got when she was a younger puppy, she I had the blessing of having a remote job. I was able to accommodate her needs as a puppy, and do all of that basic training, and just spend hours a day with just making sure, am I socializing her so she can be, a dog that I can take out in public, and is she well trained enough that I can take her out and have her, be well adjusted, in public settings, and. It took a lot to get her to that point, and she was a very high energy dog. She got overstimulated very easily, so I had to do a lot on the front end to get her to a point where I could really get her to be a dog that I can take out in public with me, because I am that person who likes to take my dogs with me to the park and to the beach and that sort of thing. My second dog, Ray, came to me as an adult dog, and she was past that stage in her life. She is actually kind of funny because she had her energy level at a 2 or 3 year old dog like a senior pup, because she was very mellow. To this day, she likes to spend most of her time napping, and then having maybe about an hour of active play every day. And now that they're 8 and 7 years old, that trajectory, they're so much more mellow now than they used to be. Harley, especially so, my puppy that I got. And so those are the benefits, right? I know with the way I work now and my lifestyle, I couldn't commit like that to another puppy. And there's so many dogs that are waiting in shelters right now who are adult dogs, who are past that puppy stage, who have just as much love to give, who are just as trainable. In fact, even more so. I like to, for speaking again from personal experience, I like to think that an adult dog is so much easier to train than a puppy, because they have less of that high energy, puppy brain of, a shiny thing happens and they're thinking squirrel. Whereas an adult dog, you give, especially if they're treat motivated or they're really interested in play, so you can get a ball, a squeaky toy, or a treat, and they'll be locked in on you. So lots of benefits to adopting an adult dog or getting an adult dog into your family. And one of the benefits that I like to say about mixed breed dogs is that they have fewer genetic health issues, because their gene pool is so much more diverse, right? They've got a mix of kind of everything and anything in them. I, again, my two dogs are mixed breed dogs. They're poi dogs. And I love this day and age of DNA tests for dogs, because it's kind of fun to see, is their personality, obviously it's unique to them, but what about their behavior is a little bit from their genetics, right? And it's kind of fun to see, what's the guessing game, what little like super mutt do I have in my home, and being able to match that up with them. So it's really fun to see, where their unique personalities come from.
That is really special. I'm just here to tell you that just sounds absolutely like an amazing experience. So, it seems that fostering is a wonderful first step for not only families, but individuals who want to see not only what kind of dog they have, but what I guess like the type of personality that they're looking for.
100%. You've absolutely nailed it, Sandy. I cannot stress this enough, that if you can go to a local rescue group or, one of Hawaiian Humane Society's campuses, both in Honolulu and Ewa, if you can go into the shelter and foster a dog, even at, treat it like a trial adoption, right? That is the most responsible thing you could do, because you don't know if this dog that you're getting from a shelter, is going to be the right fit for your home. The impression that you get and the personality of what you see in the shelter might be very different from what you see in your home. And a dog that might be very high energy in the shelter because they're in a kennel for most of their day outside of some walks with a dog walker or our team, is going to be the most mellow dog in the world once they're outside of the kennel and they have a routine. And so being able to come in and do, for Hawaiian Humane, we call it couch crashing. It's our short-term foster program for dogs. We have something similar for cats called lap crashers. But you're able to take home a dog from the shelter for 1 to 2 weeks at a time. A lot of folks do it just because it's a good thing to do. We, shelters nationwide are overcrowded, so are we here in Hawaii. So being able to take a dog out of the shelter gives them, it minimizes their stress, because they're getting out of this inherently stressful environment in a shelter where you've got lots of other strange sounds and strangers coming and going. But you're able to see what they're really like outside of the shelter, kind of get them to come out of their shell, see what they're like in a home environment, and see if they're a good fit for, if you've got residents and pets, if you've got a certain lifestyle, like you're really active and you want to see, is this going to be the right running buddy for me? If you have children and you want to see if this dog is going to be the right fit for your kids, consider fostering. There's no guilt in bringing that dog back to the shelter if it's not the right fit. Speaking from Hawaiian Humane and our Couch Crashers program, we ask all of our couch crashers to fill out a virtual report card so you're able to tell us, this is their behavior, this is what you observed in your home, so that we can best match them to the right family later on down the line. So it's a win-win. And if you fall in love and you end up deciding that this is the right dog for you, then you're going to be able to adopt that dog right into your home. And it's such a wonderful experience. We've got such great positive feedback from folks who have participated in this. But if you're going with a local shelter, with a local rescue group, same thing. They have foster programs. They are always looking for fosters. And I cannot begin to stress that fostering is just such a nice window into whether or not this dog is the right fit for you. And you don't necessarily get that opportunity when you go to a breeder, right? When you get a dog from a store or some such thing, you don't get the opportunity to say, hey, is this the right fit? You're kind of locked in. And your options then are not the best, because it's not like you can then return that dog back to that place that you got them to. Now, a responsible breeder, on the other hand, will allow you to do that. They care very much about the animals in their care. So I don't want to disparage them in any way, shape, or form, but that's kind of the benefits of adopting and fostering through a shelter.
I really appreciate that. Yes, I'm hoping that we can get some more people in there for fostering. That's a real, it's such a good program that y'all have going on.